to Amy Talk Yoga. So, I'm in a windstorm, and this is going to be restorative practice, which is really fun because it's so windy, and I hope you can hear me, and if not, just look and see what's happening. If you have a bolster, great. If you don't, an idea I just got from Jackie Bonwell, one of my teachers, is you could stuff a pillowcase full of laundry. Clean or dirty, doesn't matter. But you can make your own bolster. If you have a long scarf, great. We could use that as a strap. Or a real yoga strap is fine too. I think a scarf feels even better. So up to you. And maybe a yoga block or a book. And if you don't have those things, it's okay. It would be really nice to have a bolster today. Because we're going to do a little restorative. We're going to move a bit too. So let's come on to into child's pose to start. We'll bring our knees out wide to the edge of the mat. Our toes can touch, and we can sink our hips down. Walk our hands forward, and just stretch out. Just breathe in child's pose. Whenever you're doing any kind of yoga, if you've kind of had enough, just come on down to child's pose. But now, if you can stay there longer if you want to, but if you'd like, we're going to move into puppy. So we'll just bring our knees slightly closer together. And it's kind of the same thing,
but our bum is up in the air. So this is puppy. It could be like this with your arms engaged. Or you can just bend your elbows and have them more relaxed. Forehead just gently resting down. And if you would like it not to, you can just look forward. And we'll just slide on forward over our elbows, coming onto our belly into Sphinx.
So our elbows are under our shoulders. Our palms are pressed flat down. And it feels a little nice to look over your shoulders. I'm trying to keep my pelvis flat onto the mat. Then we're just going to move a little bit before we settle into some of our restorative poses. So, we'll just bring our hands under our shoulders. Lift up. You can come up to up dog if you want to. And then we'll just press back.
Touch our forehead down to child's pose.
Slide forward, up dog. So up dog could be with your feet pressed in and your thighs lifted. Or you can be kind of on your thighs and knees like I am. And then just shift back,
forehead touches. One more time.
Keep our spine moving. And then this time we'll tuck our toes. I'm off the back of my mat, but that doesn't matter. Tuck the toes under. Hips go high and we'll come into down dog. We'll just move around a little bit. Paddling your feet, looking under the arms. You can bend the knees. Come up on the toes. And just take little steps up to our hands. Probably can't even see my feet with this pile of stuff. Okay, so then from here, we're just going to be forward folding, looking down, and let's bring our elbows to our thighs. And we'll just gently look forward. Hanging out, chair, kind of a forward fold. Then we'll straighten our knees again and just come on up. So we're just gonna work on our hip hinge for a minute. So press, this is the part of our body we want to hinge from. So our back is long, we're shifting forward, our weight's going into the balls of the feet, but we can bring our elbows down to our knees. Our hips are still hinged. Legs don't have to be straight. We can look down at the mat, put our hands down, our knees are still soft. We can move them around, just kind of waking everything up. And then getting the knees a little bit, we'll come up and stretch our arms up over our head. Coming on down. We're just gonna do a really gentle side bend. So we'll bring our feet hip width apart, not touching. Lift our arms up, let our palms touch, and I'm gonna take hold of my right wrist with my left hand, and just a gentle drift over. Gentle. Then come on back up, take hold of my left wrist with my right hand, gentle over. Bring our hands down. I'm a weeping willow, just like these trees are going crazy around me. I have a little theme for our class. It's from the poet Hafez, come dance with me, come dance. And that's really nice. Come dance with me, come dance. It's a lovely thing if someone said that to you. But this is coming from the universe or God. So it's even better. Come dance with me, come dance. Okay. Who wouldn't want to? So let's think about that this week. See how we can engage. See how we can engage a little more. Come dance. And we'll slow our weeping willow. Even though these trees are still dancing like crazy around me. Come to just a nice little mountain pose. So our toes could be touching. We're gonna lift up through the arch of our feet. Feel everything engage. Shoulders up, back and down. So we're just gonna step through some things today because this is a restorative class. So we're just going to put our right foot forward and our left foot back about 45 degrees. Gently take our hips and let them look forward. And then we'll just look up. This could be our warrior one right here with our hands on our hips. And or we can bend into our knee as we usually do. We could lift our arms, drop our shoulders. But this is soft. It's not your deepest warrior ever. And then we'll just come on back up, let our arms come down. And let's just flip it to the back of the mat. So we'll turn our feet so that my left foot is now the front foot. I might take a step out with my foot just so they're not super narrow. Gently turn my hips. I can look up. This could be my warrior one here. Or I could bend on in and let my arms come up. A nice gentle warrior one. And then we'll come on down. Flip our feet again. We'll do warrior two the same way. Just find it, but it's soft. Kind of a soft, nice little warrior. Knees not the deepest of bends. And then we'll just straighten them, flip, and find our warrior two on this side. And straightening up, grab your blocks if you have them. If you don't, it's fine. You can do this with your hands on the ground. This might be a little easier with blocks. So I'm going to take my blocks and I'm going to put them where I would usually put my hands to start my down dog. So just put them about there. And then I'm going to step my right foot between the blocks, and my back foot is kind of down. So then I'm just going to lean forward, come up on my back toe, into a runner's lunge using the blocks, and I'm just going to press back to pyramid. So forward, runner's lunge, back to pyramid. So my heel goes down, and then it comes up. So nice on the Achilles of the back foot. One more time. And if you need to do this with your hands on the ground, because you don't have any blocks, that's just fine. And then we'll just step our foot forward, our left foot and our right foot, and our left foot will come on back. And again, leaning forward, coming up on the back toe. We want our toe to not be, our knee not to be over our toe. So if we need to, we'll just step our foot a little more forward. Gazing forward, looking back, heel comes down. The front toes might even come up. Forward. Back. Might need to have your foot in a little closer. The back foot. Totally up to you. And up. Okay, then we'll just step that foot forward and we're just going to come on down. Hands and knees, our blocks and hands, and now we're going to start the lovely restorative. So maybe you have a bolster like this, or maybe you have a pillowcase, whatever, and we're just going to take it and put it the long way on the mat, and then we're just going to sit with our knees facing, well, the most important thing is we're just pulling that bolster right up under our hip, okay? Or your pillowcase. Then we're just going to come on down on our side. Our arms will be on either side of the bolster. And your knees can come apart like mine are, or they can be on top of each other. Up to you. Then, I have to take my glasses off. Then, if you want, you can just put your head down on the bolster. This is a lovely stretch. Feels great. Or you can twist your head and put it on the other side. Go the other way. So it's totally up to you. And maybe you want to do some of both. Start with your head looking the way your legs are not, and then bring it back around. Too much on your neck, like kind of is on mine, so I'm just going to lay down here sideways. Settle in here. So if you didn't go get a bolster, if you don't have anything to use, you can just keep doing this without it. Just a nice side bend. Maybe. Together. Sure. Just lay your arm to a pillow. And that works just fine too. There's something about having the props, using the bolsters to kind of hold you up. It's really, really relaxing. I'd kind of like to just stay there all day, but when you're ready, come on up if you feel like it. Then we're just going to walk our hands up and leave our knees where they are, so our knees could either be here or here. And then we'll just twist around, look behind our shoulder. If you want to, we're going to kind of mermaid over here. Mermaid over and up. Maybe one more. Okay, so I'm just going to move my knees and have them go the other side. Bring the bolster to my other side. Okay. So just bring it right, right up to my hip, really tight. And then, knees can be together or apart. Just come on down.
One arm on either side of the bolster, and you can have a little rest here.
Or you can turn your neck.
Normal for this to feel really different on either side. It's kind of nice to have your knees apart. Just play around, see how that feels. If it can feel a more a different stretch. But it should also be comfortable and relaxing. But if it's not, find your spot where it is. If you feel ready, just come on up. I pretend like I'm timing so both sides are the same, but you can see that I'm really not. I'm just guessing. So we'll come on up and then we'll look over our shoulder toward the bolster. I'm kind of looking across the bolster. And then, if you can do this, which I'm not so great at it, you could mermaid up and over, and up and over. One more time. Okay, so coming into a heart opener, this bolster is great, but it's pretty soft. So I also have this round guy. And if you just have one, it's all fine. It'll still be great. If you want a little more lift under it, you could stick a couple blocks under your bolster. So again, we want it right up against our back. Knees can bend, and then I'm holding onto the bolster so it doesn't get pushed back, and I just lay down over the side of it. So this just feels great because my shoulders are on either side, hanging out, and my arms can just come on out. Maybe my legs go flat like that. So if you've got a pretty firm bolster, this feels good. If you don't, it just kind of feels like nothing. So, if you have the self bolster, let's play around with the blocks and see if we can make that feel good. So you can put your blocks under your bolster. Give yourself a little back bend, a little spine there. And then, come on down. That's good. It's a little high, so I'm just gonna scoot a little bit away. So you can try that. Knees bent or knees straight. And if you don't have a bolster or anything, you can just be trying to pull your shoulders down away and open. Your head a little bit.
love this and want to stay longer, you can. Stuff's just flying down on me from the trees. But we're going to switch into a forward fold, which the thing about restorative is there's a lot of fooling around with props, but then once you get there, it's kind of worth it. So I'm going to get out my, I'm going to get everything, see what I need. I'm going to get out my blocks, and I'll have one the highest way, and then I'll put one kind of the middle way. I'll put it over those blocks. And then, I'm gonna see how this feels for me to lean forward and put my head on. Doesn't feel great. It's like, going down. So what can I do? I can bring my blocks closer. And I can make both blocks stand up. See how that feels. Do this for a little bit because we already spend time looking down and looking forward. But we're gonna go to a different one in a sec. When you feel ready, just come on up from that. And we're going to do butterfly a couple of ways. First, we're going to do it sitting. So we'll put our feet together, but we'll put a block under each knee. So the blocks play around, see what setting feels good. Sometimes it doesn't feel great under your knees, but under your thighs, kind of give you a little support without pressing anything weird. And then we'll hold our ankles, sit up really tall, get our back long, and we'll just shift forward. So if that's pressing too much on the blocks, we can move them out, let our knees come out a little bit, but we've still got a nice little support there. Now our back is not so straight, and let our head drift down. And again, if you don't have blocks, you can totally just be doing this Baddha Konasana butterfly without. Take a breath. We're going to do this again on our back. So, either kind of bolster you want, press up under your back. And lean down on it. And then, as you put your feet together and your knees come out, you can tuck a block under. So we're not really, it's like making it easy for our knees to open and being so kind to our parents. Feels great. Arms out. And if it doesn't feel great, keep moving around. Find your Supta Baddha Konasana or butterfly on your back. Support it. if you love this, you can remember and come back to it for Shavasana. That's enough. You can just take the blocks out, let the knees come up, and keep the blocks. We're not quite done with them.
Come off the bolster. I have a really great leg thing for us to do. So I learned this from my new teacher training. Her name is Kathy Bonwell, and this is amazing. So, I don't know about you, but I've always wanted my legs to be longer, and this helps you get a little more space in the lower spine and in the legs. So, we're gonna take your strap or your block. If you don't have one, you can do the same thing without. And come on down to your back.
Take your strap. Let's put our right foot in the strap, across the ball of the foot. Usually what we do is pull our toes toward our nose, right? But we're not doing that this time. So left leg comes down, flat on the mat, flexing the left foot. And our right foot, we're just gonna firm everything. We're gonna firm our thigh, firm our calf, flex our foot, and then we're gonna point and flex our toes. Keep the leg really firm. Let the leg drift out to the right. So both hips are still on the ground. It might help to press down your left hip. Now, the right foot's not just hanging out in the strap. It's flexed. The whole leg is flexed. We're firming the inner thigh. Our calves are flexed. Everything's firm and good. So everything's working on this side. Our left leg, still firm, still flexed, pressing into the mat. I'm going to lift that leg back up. So these are my right toes, so I'm going to turn those toes to the right. And I'm going to hold my strap with both hands. And I'm just going to let my leg gently come to the left with my toes pointing to the right, about 10 inches across. And I can totally feel that down the IT band, down the back of my leg, into my glute. So just, it's not a really big movement. Meanwhile, my left leg still flexed, still pressing into the mat. So we're just gonna breathe, firm our leg, thigh still firm, everything's still firm. And then we'll let our leg come back to the middle, release the strap, but as we'll take our firm, firm leg and lower it down one, and to the count of 10. So count on your own, just lowering. When we get to 10, we'll be down on the mat. Still flexing both feet. Still firming both legs. And when your right leg comes down to the mat, by firming, because muscles work in pairs, so as we're firming, we're lengthening. I don't really understand anatomy that much, but that's what I heard. So, okay, let's do the other side. We want both legs long. So we'll bend our foot, put it into the strap. Now our right leg is flexed, straight on the mat. And we're going to point and flex our left foot. So it's not just that our foot that's working, our thigh's engaged. Everything's firm and working in our leg. So we'll turn our toes to the left, and we'll bring the leg a little bit to the right, about 2 inches. Really feeling that all of the way up here. And firm, firm, firm. Other foot flexed. Our beautiful long legs. Enjoy that feeling of space. So we don't have to flex them anymore. Let's just crunch our toes, roll our ankles. Flies, man, I hate them. Just breathing. And we have one last lovely restorative pose before Shavasana. Or if you'd rather not, just skip it. But it's supported bridge, so if you've got your block, bend the knees, put the feet close to the hips, just lift up, and then you can find, like, what's the right place on the block for me. Or we just put it right under the sacrum. Some people put it the long way, some people put it the across way. I think it feels good if I've got the most block possible under there. And then settle in so that shoulders are okay. Pressing down, gazing straight up, don't turn your head. And this could be it, this could be your supported bridge, you could stay right here. Or it might feel good to pick up your feet, stretch your legs up if you like. Flex the feet and point them, but you don't have to. I love supported bridge because shoulder stand is super hard for me to get my bum up off the ground. So usually I just don't even try in a public setting. But supported bridge, man, I feel like I've got all that great stuff of having your feet up, like legs up the wall. It feels so good. You can even do another Supta Baddha Konasana here. Anything you want to do with your feet. And if you would prefer pushing up into a shoulder stand without the block, do that. When you've had enough, just let your feet come on down. Maybe 1 foot at a time would feel good. And just push up and you lift the block. Just find your Shavasana. No need for nature sounds today, right? Or if it's good. bolster and stick it under your knees. That's a lovely supportive pose. You can put something else under your head. If you want to go back to Supta Baddha with the blocks underneath your knees, you can. Or you might want to do Shavasana on your side. Maybe you really liked our side bend. You can do that. Let's just consider for a couple of breaths. Come dance with me. Come dance. What could you do that you've been wanting to do? Excuse me. So, Shavasana, just soaking up all the good things that we did. Our poses, our resting, our breathing, our thinking. Enjoy. Stay where you are just as long as you like. If you feel ready, you can begin to wiggle fingers and toes. Maybe circling the wrist and the ankles. Perhaps full body stretch, arms over the head, pointing the toes away. Moving through. through water, making your way to one side, bringing the knees close to the chest. Just taking a few breaths there. Make your way to a comfortable seat. It could be Sukhasana, easy seat, or it could be a lotus with your feet up. We'll do that. And if you'd like, bring your hands to your heart. You bow the head. Breaths of gratitude. I'm always happy to be outside even when it's loud, even when the wind's blowing like crazy. I really liked the dancing trees today. It's always nice to be grateful for our bodies, for the things that they can do. Never be impatient with them. They're trying so hard to please us. We don't always give them the best fuel and the best care. And they're still doing their best. Thank you so much for practicing with me today. The light in you honors the light in you. Namaste.